The three ways AI can supercharge your finances. AI is making personal finance so much easier. The problem is most of us are not using it correctly. So here are the three ways I would do it today. Save this because this is going to make your life so much easier.
Hey everyone, and welcome to today's video. My name is Austin Bram, and I am the AI evangelist here at Integrail. And today I have a very exciting demo to show you of how you can build your own personal finance agent based off the video from that creator. This agent can take your bank statements and your credit card statements to give you a past 3 months budget to see what you've been spending on. We'll then create you a zero sum budget, give you some personalized spending tips to help you save more money, and even summarize all of this together into a MP3 file as if you're talking to an actual financial advisor. This is all for demo purposes. And make sure to consult with an actual financial advisor for professional insights. But of course, I will give the caveat here. You don't always want to give your personal information to an agent. So if you want to make it more private, you can always edit out your name, any names whatsoever, from the actual files in the first place before you actually put them into the LLM. And that's how you can provide yourself a little bit more privacy when giving this information to an LLM, because as we've all, you know, heard and learned in the past, these LLMs generally are learning based off of what you put in them. So if you put in your personal information, you're basically giving that personal information to that company. But if you want to take care of your privacy a little bit more, you can just blur all that out or just crop it out, put a white box over every part that has your name, and it'll be more private. Let's dive into Integrail's AI Studio and show you how to make it. Okay, so we're starting off on the homepage of Integrail's AI Studio. As you can see, we have a Create New Agent button. Let's go ahead and click on that, in which it will open up a blank canvas. This is the automatic agent that is built every single time that we can now build from. You have the agent outputs, the LLM node, and our agent inputs. Let's go ahead and start going over our agent inputs here. As you click into this, you can see that there are a few different options of things that you can choose to make your input. In this case, we're going to choose a few different files. Each file is going to represent a bank statement. And it's important when you're first writing out these names to have the first word as lowercase, okay? And then every time you want to click the save button, there's bank statement one. I'm gonna forward ahead to all these different bank statements. Okay, so we have our three bank statements here representing 3 months of bank statements. Now, of course, this can be extrapolated to go as far as you'd like, but for the sake of today's video, we'll just do three. And now we do the same for credit card statements. Okay, and now we have our credit card number three. And make sure for all these that you're clicking save. As you can see on the left-hand side, it is saving into our agent inputs. But as a greater idea here, whenever you do a big, you know, aspect of your agent is to make sure that you save the entire agent as a whole so that you don't lose it. There's been so many times where I've lost my agents just because I forget to save it. Okay, so now that we're working with all of these different files, what you have to have is something called a readability node, because all these files are just a bunch of data that needs to be translated into a language that a large language model or an LLM can actually follow along with. So we see here readability. Go ahead and click on that, and that will add to your canvas. Now, you need a readability node for every single file that's here. We have six files, so let's go ahead and do six readability nodes. Okay, and then when you have them all, you can just place them over close to where that original inputs are. And we can always obviously make things smaller, move things away, such we can make room for all of this. So for every single file you have, you drag over to the attachment form of the readability. And of course, if that's too small to drag from, you just scroll in to make it bigger. All right, drag it down. And there we have it. So now all of these files will be connected to the readability to actually read what's inside and put it into, if I click into this, you'll see markdown format, which is just a format that makes it easier in text format for an LLM to actually read. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to our LLM node. As you can see in the middle here, we have GPT 3.5 Turbo, but if you've been following along with AI, you know that that's a very old model. So you can change to a lot of different models here. Oftentimes people like to go to GPT 4.0 just because it's the easiest. But let's go ahead and show you some different ones that we have here. We have Claude 3.5 Sonnet, also a very popular one, as well as DeepSeek R1. And then my favorite, I actually like Gemini 2.0 from Google. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. So now that we're inside of this node here, you see a user prompt as well as system prompt. Now, system prompt, you can think of the underlying rules and guidelines that you want this LLM to follow every single time. Think of it as like adding a template so that whenever one of those readability nodes, whenever a file goes to it, it knows exactly how to spit it out and knows exactly what you're looking for. So I actually have a system prompt already written out that I'll copy in here. Okay, I'll expand this so you can see it. And here it is. Okay, so I explicitly tell it to do not interact with the user at all, because as you know, with using, you know, let's say ChatGPT or some of these chatbots in other applications, they like to talk. So by saying do not interact with the user at all, it kind of skips the actual part where it will talk to you. It'll only give out the answers, which is very nice. Act like a personal finance analyst. This is me giving it a role to follow to kind of give it the underlying. So now it knows it's only going to follow in the guidelines of a financial analyst. You specialize in reading financial statements and breaking down what is in them. Your only job is to read the connected bank statements and to pull out the relevant information from the statements. Do not include any of the fluff about interest or privacy policy, etc. Because whenever you download these bank statements, you'll see at the end, there's like pages worth of just privacy policy for the most part. And as you can notice here, I said bank statements, not credit card statements. So what we'll do here is we'll actually go ahead and take this, and I'm going to basically add another Gemini node here specifically for my credit card statements. And in this case, I have another system prompt that I'll use for this one, but it's very similar. Okay, so now you can see it's almost the exact same system prompt, but it says credit card statements instead of bank statements. Now for both of these nodes, when you open them up, once again, it'll be for both of them. Go down to chat history link, which we can think of is whenever you're talking to ChatGPT or another chatbot, you can continue on the conversation. And this will be how long you want this conversation to be able to go. Now, in this case, I actually want it to be zero because every single time that I interact with this chatbot, I almost want it to think of it being as like its own chat in the first place. So with keeping it zero, it's like every single time you interact with it, it is a new instance altogether. Now with temperature, you can think of it as creativity level. Zero being it is literally zero creative at all. It's only going to spit out what is in that exact bank statement. And as it gets closer to one, and especially two, it becomes more and more creative. Now, once you're past one, it starts getting so creative that it almost speaks gibberish. So in the case of this, I want it to be accurate of what exactly is in those bank statements and credit card statements, but a little bit of creativity involved. So my favorite is to go, you know, 0.3, anywhere between 0.3 and 0.6 when it's something that you want relatively accurate to exact information that you're looking for. And then 0.6 onwards is where it gets more and more creative, more like writing and things such as that. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing over here. Chat history length, 0, and then temperature, 0.4. Let's go ahead and save this. Okay, so now from here, what you're going to do is you have the three readability nodes from your bank statements and three readability nodes from your credit card statements. You're going to take the content and you're going to put it down into the user prompt. It can actually be either one of them. But since in this case, we already have things in our system prompt, for the ease, let's just go ahead and put it into our user prompt. So now whenever these readability and files are going into their respective LLM node, it is being broken down into the information that you see here. It's going to read the bank statements or the credit card statements and pull only the relevant information from those statements, rather than just a whole list of basically the file. So now we get to the first part that we want this agent to do. We want it to give us a past 3 month budget of what we've spent our money on in the first place, so we can actually know where is our money going. So I'm going to add on another LLM node here. Let's go ahead and look for LLM, choose on that. And then once again, just as we did with the other LLMs, you can choose whatever model you like. But like I've mentioned, I like Gemini 2.0 for its context window size, 1 million tokens, as well as its price here, effectively free. So now with this system prompt, I already have a system prompt already written out. So let's go ahead and add that in here. Okay, so now for this one, act like a personal finance analyst. You specialize in reading financial statements and breaking down what is in them. Look at the last 3 months of users' bank statements and credit card statements and tell them what each month's budget was. What was the income, expenses, and please categorize it into tabular format. Because I like it, you know, in the form of, let's say, an Excel sheet, which is basically a tabular format, making a table. Have the columns be category and amount. This can be literally whatever you want. If you have a certain way of looking at the budget that you like, you can just change it to however you'd like. So now with this case, just like we've talked about before, zero chat length. Temperature, I want it to be actually a little bit more creative. So I'm going to choose 0.5. Once again, you can change it however you'd like. And then you basically just take the output from both of those preliminary LLMs into this one LLM here. So it's taking both sides, bank statement and credit card statement, putting it into this one LLM so it can actually be read together and put into this 3-month budget. Let's go ahead and name this just for the sake of knowing what it is. Past 3-month budget. And go ahead and save. And from here, we wanted to build a zero-sum budget, which basically in the finance world basically means that every dollar you have is being allocated somewhere. So that at the end of the month or the end of the year, whatever it is, it's zero because that money is actually going to exactly where you want it to go. So we're going to add another LLM node. Okay, when that comes into the canvas, move it to wherever you'd like. Let's go ahead and just name this zero sum budget. Choose a model. Just for the sake of changing it up, I'm going to choose GPT-4o. And once again, we're going to add our system prompt. Okay, for this system prompt, we have based on the budgets as you already have created, and historically know from the past output, which is that output right there, please create a budget that the user can live on going forward and make sure that it is a zero sum budget and make sure to incorporate some fun spending. All right, here, once again, zero chat history length and then temperature. I want it to be actually more creative in this case because I wanted to think about what should this money be allocated to. So a little bit higher, 0.6. And we're gonna connect this past 3-month budget over here to our user prompt of our zero sum budget. And next we wanna have our personalized money saving tips based off of the money that we've spent and it's, you know, seen where it's actually going. So it knows, oh man, little Jimmy, you've been going to Starbucks or Chick-fil-A 3 times a week. It's gonna know that so that can actually give you some personalized feedback on where you should be saving your money at. So let's go ahead and add another LLM. Move it to wherever you'd like. Let's name it Money Saving Tips. Let's change over to, for the sake of changing things up, Claude 3.5. Once again, I have already pre-written system prompt. All right, let's expand this to show you, based on the budgets from the past 3 months, as well as the zero sum budget, provide 5 ways that the user, you, can save money without feeling it in their day-to-day spending. But of course, if you want to feel it, if you want to save as much as humanly possible, just change it to tell that. Zero chat history length. And then temperature, I actually want this to be even more creative here. It's going to be thinking about what exactly you should be doing to save money. As per usual, save. And then we want to almost everything can be connected to this past 3-month budget because that's where the true data is coming from. So I'm connecting it to that node right here. And of course, an important part of these tips is knowing what is going to be based off of that zero-sum budget. So I'm going to connect this zero-sum budget as well. So there we go. Now we've just added those money tips. So now kind of the last functionality is being able to take all this information, summarize it into what would be like a conversation with your actual financial analyst, which involves, as per usual, adding another LLM. So I'm going to put that up here. So let's go ahead and call this financial summary. Okay. I chose Gemini 2.0 as my favorite. Now let's go over ahead to system prompt where once again, I have a pre-written system prompt that I'll copy into here. Okay. So act as a professional financial advisor for the top celebrities in the world. Of course, I chose this because they're probably going to have the best financial advisors. So you can change it to politicians or Joe Schmo on the street, whatever you want. Based on all the budget information from those last 3 different nodes, the past 3 months, the zero sum budget, and the tips, summarize it all in such a way that is both fun and informative. This summary will be what you say to the client as you're sitting face to face, and you treat them like your family every single time. I want this to actually have a zero chat history as per usual, and a much more creative summary here, which is going to be 0.8. It can be higher than this if you'd like, but I find that 0.8 is probably the best for this. I'll go ahead and save it. And then like the other ones, I want the general information to actually come from all of these different nodes here in the first place. So it can summarize all of that information. All right. And then the last part that actually makes it able to speak to you is we have here a very special node that you can see is OpenAI text-to-speech or just normal text-to-speech. They both do very similar things. Okay, so I have OpenAI text-to-speech. Let's just call this financial advisor agent. And for the voice, you can try out all the different voices if you'd like. I just know that I like Onyx because it reminds me of my kind of like Google Assistant that I talk to on my phone. So I just chose that one because I like it already. I've already used it before. And then from here, you're going to put all that information from this financial summary into this last text-to-speech. Now, when you have all of this created, notice how nothing is actually put into our agent outputs. Like it says, where you get all this information. Depending on what information you want given, let's say you only want that summary at the end, all you have to do is then put one output to the agent outputs. But for the sake of that I like to do it, I want all of this information because, you know, and more information is always going to be better for you. So I have this financial summary and slash financial advisor going here to my outputs. I also want these money saving tips. I want to know what this past 3 month budget is, as well as I want to know what this zero sum budget is. So from here, now you have all this information, this entire agent is created. So for the sake of just going over what we've seen so far, we have the past 3 months of our bank statements right here and our credit card statements. Those are going into readability nodes so they can actually be read by an LLM. We have our bank statements and our credit card statements separately being read and put into a general LLM to kind of sparse out all the relevant information, put into our past 3 month budget. And based off of this past 3 month budget, we want to then make a zero sum budget. We want to have some specialized money saving tips. And then for all of it together, the financial summary, as well as the text to speech, where it's almost like you're sitting down with your financial advisor. Now, for the sake of not showing you my personal finances, you can try this out with your finances, or you can always find some dummy data. Hopefully this shows you all that an agent can do to help you with your personal finances, as well as gives you an idea of, wow, if I can do, you know, this X, Y, and Z with that readability node and all these different LLMs, it'll give you some ideas of what you can make personally that will help you in your everyday life. But it can go all the way down to, I've made social media agents in the past, which you can see on this channel. You can make project management agents. Honestly, the world is your oyster here. Now remember, we are not financial advisors, so this is not financial advice. This is merely showing you what can be done on our AI Studio platform. If you like this video and you like demos like this, make sure to like and subscribe to our Integrail YouTube channel, as well as check out some of the other demos and other videos that we have to help you get used to building things on AI Studio. Thanks for watching.